open questions that there.
So solution for this.
compensated. Distinguished guests, parents and family, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Spring 2016 Commencement Ceremony for RIT Kosovo. This is a joyous day for all of our graduates and for all of us, especially those 133 graduates who today close one significant chapter in their lives and at the same time open another, embarking upon what we hope will be for all of them a prosperous and successful future. I congratulate not only the graduates themselves, but their parents, their families, and their friends for making the necessary sacrifices and providing the necessary encouragement and support for them to complete their baccalaureate degree. All countries need the best talent of their youth, but this is especially so in a young country such as Kosovo, where the future holds great promise, but harbors many risks as well. My hope is that the education provided by RIT Kosovo to these young men and women has instilled in them a determination to pursue not only their personal success and happiness, but the improvement of the country and the society which so greatly needs their talents. I take this opportunity to thank personally our faculty for their dedication to the students, our staff for their constant support, our Board of Trustees for its guidance of the institution, Rochester Institute of Technology for its cooperation, and the City of Pristina and the Government of the Republic of Kosovo for your support and encouragement. Thank you, one and all. To our graduates, I extend my best wishes for fulfilling lives and successful careers. And my hope is that your fond memories of your years at RIT Kosovo will remain with you always. Yurimi. At this point, I would like to mention the names of the platform party, ask them to stand briefly as their name is called. Sandra Johnson of RIT, Jim Myers of RIT, Daniel Cosentino, Eliana Halili, Ambassador Greg Dellowy, Edmund Choku, a member of the Board of Trustees, Dritan Mazzini, a member of the board, Safa Boga, Board of Trustees, Nancy Bekovac, Board of Trustees, Vlasnim Zhiha, Acting Chairman of the Board, Julieta Mishkilai, Member of the Board, Bersant Disha, and Ardiana Bunyako, also members of the Board of Trustees. As the Senior Vice President for Student Affairs, Dr. Sandra Johnson oversees the university's student life, wellness, student learning, and athletics departments. She's been a leader in increasing one's spirit, student connectivity, and development of our RIT Kosovo student government. Finally, I am pleased to announce that in cooperation with RIT, we are recognizing a strengthening of our partnership. Henceforth, in recognition of the close relationship with RIT, I am pleased to announce that AUK will be officially known and branded both here and abroad as RIT Kosovo. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Sandra Johnson.
Thank you, Dr. Thompson, and all the incredible RIT Kosovo students, faculty, and staff for the warm welcome. Graduation day is a joyous day for our university. It is a day to put aside the administrative meetings, assignments, and endless grading. It is a day to celebrate our students and their many successes. I am very happy to be here today to celebrate our wonderful graduates. It is my honor to announce the student awards for the RIT Outstanding Undergraduate Scholars. This year, there are 7 students who have been awarded the RIT Outstanding Scholar Award, a testament to RIT Kosovo's hardworking and highly deserving students. Each of the students honored today has achieved the distinction of maintaining a minimum institute grade point average of 3.85 at a possible 4.0. In addition, selection of the students was based on other factors of academic achievement, such as creative work, service on student committees, civic activities, employment, and independent research. Would each student, as I call your name, please approach the stage? I kindly ask that all of you hold your applause until all of the students have joined me on the stage. Milat Borakhni. Nida Krasnichi. Alketa Buchai. Ileana Halali. Daoris Sahachiyu. Begatim Bereisha. Ileana Kukai. Ladies and gentlemen, please give an outstanding applause to the RIT Outstanding Scholars. Congratulations, students.
Thank you, Dr. Johnson. I am Daniel Cosentino, Vice President for Academic Affairs at RIT Kosovo. This year, we have 2 students who have produced special messages to share with us today. It is my honor to first introduce valedictorian Ileana Halili. Following the valedictorian address will be highest honors student and winner of this year's commencement speech competition, Alketa Buchai.
Dear members of the Board of Trustees, President Thompson, Associate Provost Myers, Dr. Sandra Johnson, dear distinguished guests, family members, faculty and staff, dear almost graduates, what does success mean to you? When we look at successful people, we acknowledge them, we praise them, we envy them. We see them shine, but what we don't see are the challenges they faced or the strenuous efforts they made to arrive to the point where they are now. To us, their success seems sudden, but it's actually the result of small, unnoticeable, and incremental steps that led those people to success. I'd like to compare our 4-year AUK journey to a 4-kilometer marathon run. Imagine yourself standing at the starting line on September 3rd, 2012 at 8 a.m., where we had our first class at AUK. At the beginning, you didn't see the destination. You didn't even see the route to the destination. You just hoped that you would make it to the finish line. Without any fears, you started running. Next to you were various competitors, equipped with different attitudes, expectations, and goals. Some wanted to finish the marathon in 20 minutes, others in 45, and yet others didn't mind the time. They just wanted to reach the finish line. After the first kilometer, you were still in a good shape and motivated. You made really good friends along the way, joking around, and who made the time go quicker. After the second and third kilometer, however, you started getting tired. This exhaustion is a consequence of all-nighters before exams, stress before deadlines, and the attempt to still enjoy student life at parties. As you reached the fourth kilometer, your knees began to hurt and breathing became difficult. Lifting your legs became heavier and you felt that you've reached your limits. When you've looked up, you saw your cheerleaders on the sidelines. These were your family, friends, and professors who believed in you and who encouraged you to keep running because the reward is going to be beneficial. Appreciate and thank them today for their continued support all along the marathon. Today, on Wednesday, May 11, 2016, you finally reached the finish line, and we will proudly receive our trophies. Congratulations on completing this big marathon. Success has a different meaning to different people. It can be achieving a high GPA, supporting your family, helping out in a shelter, committing to the diet that you've been pushing so long, or being able to hold down 10 shots of tequila. But the marathon comparison teaches us the following. Successful people did not become successful right away. They have overcome challenges and made sacrifices. They have shown commitment, determination, persistence, and motivation. We can have this wonderful university. We can have dedicated professors and supporting families, but in the end, it's only you and only you who needs to run. During your AK marathon, you raised your hand in class, you've done your homework, you've finished your group tasks, you've completed an endless number of essays, presentations, and exams. And even though these were small things, they summed up to the success you have right now. Remember, it takes small, unnoticeable, and incremental steps to be successful. As Marva Collins said, success doesn't come to you. You go to it. Thank you.
Members of the Board of Trustees, President Thompson, Vice President Cosentino, family members, faculty and staff, and fellow graduates. On our first day at RIT, a very wise professor quoted, "We were all meant to shine. It is not just in some of us, it is in everyone." As I am looking at all of you here today, I'm realizing that indeed, every single one of us is shining. I am honored to be here today and represent class of 2016. But before I continue, I would like to say congratulations. This is the day we've been waiting for.
family and friends. I know that right now you feel so rewarded for all the hard work you have put into all of us and proud of all of our accomplishments. Faculty members, this is just another class that you have magnificently educated. Without you, our graduation would be meaningless. Yet, I do know that nothing can compare to the feelings that we, the graduates, have right now. We made it. We survived all those quizzes, exams, and research papers. Here at AUK, we have all found professors who went above and beyond teaching their classes, who helped us grow, not only academically, but in every possible sense of the word. We all remember this one professor who always showed us stories about his dogs, cats, and kids. We even saw pictures of them every day in class. Some of us decided to study law, human rights, or international relations because of this amazing professor who inspired us in each of his lectures. We learned that there are bears and wildcats at the Shore Park, and this professor made sure to remind this to us every time we went there. We realized that accounting isn't easy, but we had a real pro teaching it to us. We also had one professor who always complained that in his time, there were no cell phones, and whenever he had to meet someone during a snowstorm and they didn't show up, they just had to assume they were eaten by wolves and move on with their lives. Funny thing is, this professor is not even that old. We learned that quotes in every short story analysis are our evidence, but we should never let them speak for themselves. We learned that life is like math. If it looks easy, you must be doing something wrong. And lastly, we learned the most important thing in economics is that there is no such thing as a free lunch. We will never forget the ideals that were instilled in us from the very first day. Each one of us has had the privilege of having these amazing people as our professors. I would like to take a moment and thank them for all the hard work and the profound impact they had on our lives. AUK has helped us appreciate education through many lenses. We studied management, immersed ourselves in arts, read history, debated politics, struggled with calculus. God knows how much we struggled with calculus. And we scrutinized the economy. It is this wealth of knowledge that truly leads us out of ignorance and brings out the best in us. However, when we get a job or go to grad school, or become military officers, we are not going to remember the tests we aced, or the classes we struggled with, or the endless nights in front of a computer screen. Instead, we're going to remember the good times we had, the crazy parties, the RIT1 Spirit Festival, where some of us were wearing sumo wrestling costumes, the beer pongs in the backyard, the dinners we had, and the laughs we shared. Today, we can truly say we have had 4 years filled with joy. Remember the first day we took the ID pictures? It's interesting they never changed them, but funny to go back and look just how young and childish we looked 4 years ago. We have changed a lot. Some of us even got married or engaged, and some of us will do so in the next few years. But one thing's for sure, we will always be those young 18-year-olds in our ID pictures. The diploma that we receive today signifies success, but what it's really carved in my mind and my heart is the journey we have had until here. Today, we will start a new chapter in our lives, stronger than ever, and we owe it all to our families, to our professors, and to our university. So, starting today, work hard, don't procrastinate, and try putting your iPhones down once in a while. We know what we are, but know not what we may be, said William Shakespeare. As graduates of RIT, I believe we can do anything and become who we aspire. So, class of 2020.
began this journey eager to create a better future for ourselves and our community. When we first came here, we did not know anyone, but now we live as a family. And I believe this is the greatest gift that AUK has given to us. Thank you.
Thank you very much to our outstanding students. It gives me great pleasure now to introduce our 2016 commencement speaker, Ambassador Greg Delawey. Mr. Delawey was sworn in as the Ambassador of the United States to Kosovo on July 24, 2015. He presented his credentials to President Yayaga on August 21st. Previously, Mr. Delawey served as Deputy Assistant Secretary for Verification, Planning, and European Security in the State Department's Bureau of Arms Control, Verification and Compliance. In prior assignments, Mr. Delawey served as the Deputy Chief of Mission at the U.S. Embassy in Berlin, where he was Chief Operating Officer of one of the largest missions abroad for the United States. As Deputy Assistant Secretary in the Bureau of Political Military Affairs, where he was the State Department's lead on counter-piracy issues and managed programs regarding humanitarian negotiations and statutes, forces agreements, and as Deputy Chief of Mission of the U.S. Embassy in Zagreb, and in various positions in Rome, Ankara, and Frankfurt. In other Washington assignments, he worked on bilateral trade issues, human resources policy, aviation security, and as desk officer for the Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development. He served also as watch officer for the State Department Operations Center. Mr. Delawey's foreign languages include German, Italian, Turkish, and Croatian. As a member of the Senior Foreign Service, he graduated from Harvard College with a degree in economics. He's originally from San Diego, California, is married to Vonda Kimball Delawey, also a Foreign Service officer. The Delaweys have two children time here in Kosovo. Please join me in welcoming Ambassador Delawey.
Hello, everybody. Members of the Board of Trustees, President Thompson, Vice President Cosentino, representatives from RIT, families, friends, students, and most importantly, members of the 2016 graduating class of the American University in Kosovo. Vidita, Dobadan, good afternoon. Are you all happy? I remember. It's a pleasure to be here with you today to mark the 12th commencement of AUK and to honor your hard work and accomplishments over the past 4 years. You have survived and you have thrived. From your first writing seminar to your immersions, you arrived on this campus 4 years ago from different places and different backgrounds, yet today you sit here united, not just by the caps and gowns that you wear, but by the experiences that you share. You are united by the classes you've taken, the activities in which you've participated, and the projects that you've developed. But above all, you you are united by the knowledge that you have gained and by the common goal that you share, to make your mark on the world as a member of the AUK class of 2016. It is true that AUK holds a special place in this country. Each of you is one of only around 1,000 students who have earned an American degree while studying in Kosovo. You are soon to be part of an alumni network that stretches worldwide, but whose strength remains right here in Pristina. Just as those who have walked before you, you will be professors, doctors, lawyers, public servants. You will one day be members of parliament, civil society leaders, or business executives. This is the great power of this institution. But with great power comes great responsibility, and your great responsibility is soon to come. Today is a celebration of how far you have come during your time at AUK. But I know that for some of you, perhaps many of you, today also comes with a sense of uncertainty. After years of order and schedule, be in class at this time, complete this assignment, study for this test, it's hard to face a future full of unknowns. Which elective to take turns into which job to apply for. How will I afford tuition becomes how will I afford the rent. These are realities for even the best and brightest of students. It's also the feeling that many people have around Kosovo today, more than 8 years after independence. Where is Kosovo headed, and how will it get there? As ambassador, I often speak with youth like you, and I often hear about the uncertainties and insecurities that come with being a 20 or 30 something in Kosovo. When will we be able to travel? Why doesn't the government represent people like me? Will there be a job for me? I can imagine that some of these concerns are very real for many of you today. Whether or not you've secured a job or a space in graduate school, this uncertainty, this insecurity, is unfortunately pervasive in today's society. And I often hear it coming back to one key issue, one issue that I swear is the elephant in every single room in Kosovo. The one thing that everyone thinks they understand, but no one seems to solve: corruption. Now, there are lots of issues related to corruption that we could talk about today, but if I may, let's bring the conversation back to you, the graduates, 133 of Kosovo's best and brightest looking to make a difference, and some of you looking for a job. We know that finding employment in a public institution nowadays is very difficult without connections, and that the easiest way to get a job is to gain favor through political or family influence. Qualification and merit are often not the most important factors, and many public sector jobs are filled without an open competition. On the other hand, a mismatch between skills required by the private sector and those found in the labor pool and slow private sector growth has left thousands of college graduates searching for employment. We see the discussions that go on in the cafes of downtown Pristina, and we grumble and moan about the problems and politics of a system so entrenched that we feel is powerless, we're powerless to change. This too is the uncertainty of a nation still in its formative years. Politics in Kosovo are heated. Some might even call them divisive. But let's be clear about one thing. Corruption in Kosovo is not a political issue. Corruption in Kosovo is a societal issue. It is a healthcare issue, an academic issue, an economic issue. Corruption isn't just a barrier to economic growth or the development of a skilled civil service. It's a barrier to jobs and to wage growth. And the crazy thing about systemic corruption, it affects everyone. When you pay a little extra to get an official document, so does everyone else in line behind you. When you get turned away from a job that was never really open, there are hundreds of other applicants just like you. Hundreds of people who want change, but who have hundreds of different excuses for why that change will never come. my short time in Kosovo, I've heard them all. Politics will never change. It's the culture of the Balkans. At least we're better than our neighbors. But there's one other thing that I hear all too often. I can't do anything about it. This is the statement that hurts me the most, a simple statement of uncertainty and insecurity that doesn't stand for change. It flies a white flag in the midst of defeat. But if you always do what you always do, you'll always get what you always got. It's true, change does not come on its own. And herein lies your great responsibility. AUK class of 2016, I know that you understand the reality and the urgency that Kosovo faces today. We often call you Kosovo's leaders of tomorrow, and I mean that sincerely. You are Kosovo's next great generation of politicians, businessmen and women, and civil society leaders. But remind yourselves that you're also the doers of today. And there are things that you can do now. You, as an entire student body, can refuse to pay for things like grades. You can refuse to pay for doctor's appointments and healthcare that you're already entitled to. And when you see corruption, you can report it. Let the anti-corruption agency know what is going on. Take to social media. There's already a hashtag out there, I paid a bribe, that you can use. But perhaps even more importantly, you can be the change you want to see. Become the kind of professional you would want to work with in your field. Don't be that person who has 10 jobs and 10 salaries, but does none of them. And above all, don't accept that corruption is a given. I have heard here that there is an analogy which describes Kosovo citizens as good sprinters, but not good marathon runners. Practice that marathon. Don't give up and accept the status quo. I'm guessing that many of you heard that famous Victor Hugo line, "Nothing is as powerful as an idea whose time has come." It is a powerful message that has been echoed from the French Revolution to the American Civil Rights Campaign and to Arab Spring activists. But with all due respect to those true heroes, I'd like to add one thing. Societies don't change because of great ideas alone. They change because of great people who harness great ideas. Great people who develop, promote, and implement change. Great people who embody that change. You, the graduates of AUK from 2016, are great people with great ideas. You've spent 4 years developing your minds and sharpening your skills for this very moment. You can make that change happen now. In fact, as graduates of this esteemed university, I dare say that we expect that of you. No. We don't expect you to move mountains, but we absolutely expect you to kick up some dirt. Martin Luther King Jr. once said, "If you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward." This message is as true for you as it is for your country. The uncertainty will fade away. The change will come. Kosovo will keep moving forward if you keep moving forward. AUK class of 2016, congratulations, Ureme, Chestitan. Today, celebrate that journey that has brought you to this stage. But tomorrow, focus on the journey that you have ahead, a journey where you become the leaders you want to see, and Kosovo becomes the country you want it to be. Success, Srećno, good luck. I'm counting on you.
Thank you, Ambassador Deloey. You inspire us by your words and your leadership, and as a U.S. citizen, I want to thank you for your service. It's my privilege now to introduce Ul Lamani. Ul, take the stage.
Hi everyone, I'm Ul Lamani. I'm an AAK student. This is my friend Murat on the guitar. We're here to perform and honor class of 2016. And hopefully I will be sitting next to you where you're sitting now. So we hope you enjoy your performance. The things you do, from the way you talk to the way you move. Everybody here is watching you, 'cause you feel like home. You're like a dream come true. If by chance you're here alone, can I have a moment before I go? 'Cause I've been by myself all night long, hoping you saw love I used to know. Like a movie, you saw me the soul. My God, this reminds me of when we were young. And if I tell you it's love, we can't see it's a loss. And don't be mad, be excited, love me. It was just like a song. I was so scared to face my fears. Nobody told me that you'd be here. And I swear you won't ever see. That's what you said when you left me. You still look like a movie. You still sound like a song. My God, this reminds me of when we were young. We Now we have a more fun song that is it's what you're gonna do after graduate, but hopefully not, but please. Today I don't feel like doing anything. I just want to work in my head. I feel like making up my phone.
Wow. Now that's how you celebrate a graduation, isn't it? Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It is with the greatest pleasure that I travel to Kosovo each year to participate in the commencement ceremonies and to congratulate all the graduates for reaching this milestone in their lives. In a world in which knowledge is increasingly the differentiator between the successful and the unsuccessful, you are now in a position to make a meaningful contribution to your community, your nation, and the world. It is also a pleasure to acknowledge the families, wives, children, friends of the graduates. It is your support which has in so many cases helped to bring the graduates to this place at this time. The graduates will continue to need your support as they venture forward. At this time, I ask the audience and our special guests to join me in recognizing the people who by their support, love, and encouragement have contributed so much to the success of these graduates and are here to celebrate with us today. So listen carefully. Would the parents of the graduates please rise and be recognized? would the spouses, partners, and children of the graduates please rise? Are there any spouses or? Yeah. And last but certainly not least, would the grandparents of the graduates please rise? Thank you all very much. RIT Kosovo AUK has prepared you well, but you should remember that this is not the end, but the beginning of your education. The most successful graduates are those who continue to learn throughout life and to apply that learning to their work. Finally, the RIT Kosovo, formerly the American University in Kosovo, is not really an American university, but rather an international partnership of the kind that we will increasingly need if we are to work together globally toward our shared goals. As you continue through your careers, I hope that you will celebrate both your own national heritage and our common citizenship on planet Earth. We have nothing to lose and much to gain from working together for the betterment of all. Once again, congratulations and best wishes to the graduate. It is now my pleasure to confer the RIT Bachelor of Science degree upon our graduates. My pleasure, however, is minor compared to those directly responsible for the academic success of our graduates. I speak of the faculty. They are the teachers, the advisors, the mentors of our students. I ask their graduating students to join me in honoring the RIT Kosovo faculty for a job well done. Could the RIT Kosovo faculty please rise and be recognized? Tomorrow you begin another journey. Whatever journey you have chosen, be it continuing your studies, starting your career, or engaging in public service, you have the knowledge and skills to be successful and to make a difference. Use them well. Kosovo, the region, and the world need you and your expertise. Now, by the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents of the State of New York, and the Board of Trustees of Rochester Institute of Technology, I now confer upon you the degree to which you are entitled as certified by the faculty and as signified in the commencement bulletin with all the rights and privileges thereto. On behalf of all of the faculty, staff, and administration of RIT and RIT Kosovo, congratulations to the class of 2016. For the moment that everyone has been waiting for. During this part of the ceremony, we will recognize each graduate for his or her accomplishments. As a courtesy to all the graduates and their guests, we ask that the graduates to return to your seat after you've crossed the stage and to remain seated until the end of the ceremony. I thank you in advance for your cooperation. Dr. Thompson, members of the board, Dr. Johnson, it is now my pleasure to present to you the candidates of the Bachelor of Science in Applied Arts and Science degree.
Begatim Berisha, highest honors. Milad Burane, Amici, highest honors. Dar Sahacio, highest honors. Erand Abozi, honors. Granet Ademe. Getor Agushi, high honors. Valentina Alievich. Zona Aliu. Glerta Avdiu, honors. Idea Azire. Linda Balidemic. Mergen Begole. Anila Bahramai, honors. Ariana Bechiri, highest honors. Lyra Bechiri, honors. Marigona Bechiri, honors. Marigona Bechiri. Adrian Berisha. Dylan Berione. Sihona Bina. Etnik Blokai. Klamor Breznica. Alkate Buchar, highest honors. Kushtrem Cernobrego. Brikena Doku, honors. Premtem Dervishai, high honors. Vesa Deva, honors. Nita Dubovce. Leonida Dushe. Spat Dushe. Liri Efendio. Laura Eyupe. Behar Fazlio. Deborah Fona. Adonis Gossi. Anel Gossi. Exon Gossi. Emira Gossi. Ilira Gossi. Valmer Gossi. Zjem Grjaliu. Krenore Gjikoli. Besa Gjombolaj. Dardane Gjota, honors. Dior Halili. Kemal Halite. Dorun Valentina Honza, Rina Hapcio, Blerina Hassani, Drilan Hassani, Elira Hassani, Erinda Hazire, Ermelinda Hazire, highest honors. Basfort Hussaini, Ilir Ibrahimi, Margine Ibrahimi, high honors. Shpat Ibrani, Adea Idrizai, Rilend Idrizi, Dranush Isufi, Angelush Yanuzi, high honors. Laurita Yusai, Eden Kabashi, Evelina Kabashi, Hana Kaidontai, Imret Kasapoli, Adriana Castrote, Gaspar Colani, Granet Krasniche, Tringa Krasniche, high honors. Iliriana Kukai, highest honors. Zümer Kukalay, Agnesa Koche, honors. Basfort Kurteche, Dielza Lehu, Arlend Letaya, Yeta Yoshai, high honors. Laureta Lume, Goza Maksute, Visar Marki, Chlerem Morina, Donika Mucholi, Labat Muyota, Albiana Murtese, Rinar Mustafa, honors. Urtan Mustafa, Jamal Mzio, Shand Namlegio, Vende Nazife, Albina Osmane, Guri Panduri, honors. Haji Pista, Liridon Roma, Eneida Recica, Nora Rugova, high honors. Tarina Rugova, honors. Anita Selmane, Abdurrahman Shabane, Marigona Shabane, Shabane. Linera Shala. Robert Shala. Yeta Statovce High Honors. Angie Susuri Highest Honors. Lurika Tahiri High Honors. Eugen Fauci. Nderem Veselai. Rita Vula Honors. Rina Zubi High Honors. Agnesa Zhugole. Rina Zhugole. Gazmend Zulfio.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have seen before you today the future of Kosovo and the future of this region. The quality of our graduates, their passion for learning, their struggles for an education in many cases while holding responsible full-time jobs, the sacrifices of their families that have been made to bring them to these days, all these fill me with the certainty that among these young people are the leaders who will take Kosovo into a bright, peaceful, and prosperous future. We are all very proud of you. Would the RIT Kosovo graduates please rise? As graduates, you may move your tassels from right to left, signifying your graduation. I salute your accomplishments. I wish you well in both your personal and professional lives. Congratulations to the class of 2016. Ladies and gentlemen, graduates, I ask that you please be seated. and that the aisle will be cleared so that the platform party can leave the stage. Thank you to you all. You're invited to a reception in the garden. Please clear the aisle.